discriminate in crack cocaine versus powder cocaine. It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent. If you want.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
We need to make sure you have a president in the White House who actually sees you and who has your back. A Harris administration together with Joe Biden as the president of the United States.
Oh, did I say that out loud?
A Harris administration with Joe Biden as the president of the United States.
There's two kinds of words, inside words and outside words. Inside words stay in, outside words come out. That time an inside word popped out.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Do I do it now? Bishop, you want me on now?
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
You need a lot of energy to do this job properly. You can't be sitting in your basement for 4 days and come out. No, and then he comes out, and I like Delaware. I think Delaware is a good place, but you got to leave it on occasion, you know. I mean,
who's your captain? Howie Carr.
It is a historic day at the Trump White House. The delegation from Bahrain also here. The Prime Minister of Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu, is here. Israel to sign normalization of relations documents with the UAE and with Bahrain. This brokered with the help of the Trump administration. Again, a historic day.
After decades of division and conflict, we mark the dawn of a new Middle East. In Israel's entire history, there have previously been only two such agreements. Now we have achieved two in a single month. And there are more to follow.
Unchained and unstoppable.
It's been incredible what we've done, because we're going to have a vaccine in a matter of weeks. Now, will it be before the election? It could be, in terms of we have something and we'll start delivering it immediately upon getting it.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Welcome to the Howie Carr Show. The telephone number, if you'd like to join us, is 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. And we have much to get to here today. And Joe Biden is back out on the campaign trail, however briefly. The president is at the White House with Benjamin Netanyahu and the leaders of a couple of the Arab nations that have signed peace accords today with Israel. This is a great victory for the Trump administration and for world peace, I would say. And of course, it's being downplayed by the mainstream alt-left media. They're not going to give him a Nobel Prize under any circumstances. Anyway, 844-500-4242. So you just heard Kamala Harris referring to the Harris administration with Biden as president, and Biden just did it himself right now, just about an hour ago in Philadelphia. Cut 16.
Harris Biden administration is going to relaunch that effort.
He doesn't even know what he's running for. I thought he was running for the Senate. You know, he got into the Senate after he was in Congress. The House. Oh, no, that's right. He was confused about that, too. He was on the Wilmington City Council, not the U.S. House of Representatives.
In his defense, in very rare exception, once a vice president, always a vice president.
Yes, yes. I think it was John Nance Garner. He was the vice president for FDR in the first two terms. And he said, I guess I can say the word. He said the vice presidency is not worth a pitcher of warm piss. And they later changed that to warm spit. But everybody knew that he used a different four-letter word than spit. And it still is. And someone once described somebody as having the soul of a vice president. Yes, Grace?
Do you think, obviously with Kamala Harris, it was a Freudian slip. She knows she's going to be more in charge than Joe Biden, so she said the Harris administration with Joe Biden. But for him to come out the day after and say the Harris Biden, do you think they told him to say that to make it seem like she wasn't conspiring against him, like they're both on the same page?
No, I think he was just misreading the teleprompter again. He always keeps screwing up the teleprompter. And it's getting worse too.
Or did was the teleprompter right, and Kamala Harris read it correctly, then said that's not right and tried to switch it around, but Biden read it correctly and didn't bother fixing it?
I do not know. I do not know the answer to that.
These conspiracy theories run deep.
Yes, that's a sorrowful mystery, as they used to say in CCD. So let's have some more Biden cuts here before we get going. Might as well go with the Biden cuts. Did you find Fallen Angels yet? Is that around? He referred to dead U.S. military as fallen angels. And again, CCD, you know, that's what they call Lucifer, was a fallen angel, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, they say when your mind goes, sometimes you go back to your childhood. So maybe he's back in CCD. It's, you know, it's 1932 in Scranton, Pennsylvania. And this is what where he thinks he is. I don't know. Let's hear it.
How many people died or wounded in these wars? Because every one of them left behind a community. Every one of those fallen angels left behind, and we owe them. It's not 56,870, 6,678 precisely.
Oh, okay. This is that's a different cut. That's the wrong cut. We've got him. I guess he said it before. We just we didn't have it, but we'll get it. So let's have him just. I'm just looking at the cut sheet here. Biden mumbles. I can always go for a Biden mumbles cut. 17.
Quite frankly, I won't say get angry. Quite frankly, makes me very upset.
Quite frankly, where am I? Quite frankly, what is this? These words that are scrolling by me on a screen that looks like a television screen.
The fact is that I don't remember.
Where I watch Matlock every night down in the basement while I'm eating my tapioca pudding. All right. Cut 19.
That's why the VA has more specialized knowledge about how to treat veterans' unique health needs.
Veterans. The VA, the Veterans Administration. Okay, cut 18.
As reported from a very reliable source and confirmed by many major outlets, that he said to a fallen father, a member of the service, the father of a fallen soldier, who himself was a member of the service.
May we quote you on that, Mr. Vice President? All right. 844-500-4242-413. Am I wrong in thinking the Biden campaign claiming he is terrified of getting COVID-19 is just an excuse to get out of the debates and to cover for it? Yes. The Politico, which is a Democrat tip sheet in D.C., is saying that the Biden campaign is handling him with kid gloves and keeping everybody away from him because they're so worried about COVID-19. And Rush was just speculating, and it's obvious, I believe, that they're just trying to lay the groundwork for getting out of this. The first debate is 2 weeks from tonight, and it could be key to the entire race, because if he really comes out stumbling, mumbling, dementia Joe, I mean, I don't know how even people who hate Trump can vote for a guy like that. How can they? I don't know.
His campaign manager just refused to answer whether he uses a teleprompter in regular questions.
How do you respond to the criticism that has, we've seen this all over, about the vice president using a teleprompter during some of these interviews?
Oh, well, I mean, first of all, I would say very clearly the vice president uses a teleprompter on occasion. You see it as giving a speech, but he is also out there every day taking questions from reporters.
No,
you're
he's
seeing
not.
That today. He's in Florida and will continue to take questions. I think he took questions four or five times out on the stump and out of his travel last week. So,
Mr. Vice President, what's your favorite flavor of ice cream?
Howie, I have another question.
Do you prefer caramel or hot fudge on your sundae? Yes, Grace.
So Biden has had a couple of interviews with people like Jake Tapper. If he had a teleprompter in those interviews, you're a reporter. If you were interviewing someone going for that high a job, the highest job in the land, and they had a teleprompter, wouldn't you feel it was your duty as a journalist to say, I can't interview you if you're reading off a teleprompter? And I have to tell the people watching this that you're reading off a teleprompter.
But Jake Tapper is not a journalist. He is a Democrat operative masquerading as a journalist.
We should like ask
Stephanopoulos,
Jake
Tapper. Like F. Chuck Todd. All these people are Democrat operatives, Grace. I mean, this is not secret stuff. This is in the, maybe it's not on their Wikipedia pages because they've cut it, but they all got their start in so-called journalism by being coat holders for Democrats, corrupt Democrats at that. You have to get ahead in journalism today, Washington mass media journalism, by being a lackey, a minion of corrupt Democrats. That's the way you move up. It's not like the old days when you started out at like a little paper and then you moved up to a medium size, to a large paper, and same thing for TV stations. It's not that way now. Nobody goes through what amounts to the journalistic equivalent of basic training. They all just learn by being in a campaign. First, they're getting coffee for the campaign, and then they're covering the campaigns. And the only thing they do, they don't do any, there's no follow-up questions. You can see it from Biden. They're given the questions by the campaign to ask. And then the only follow-up is when they're handed some kind of opposition research to ask Republicans about. That's all they do. And then if anybody pushes back, like, what was it, Peter Navarro the other day, you just cut him off. And you end the segment early and you go to an early break. And then you come back and you've got some other Democrat operative with a press pass that you're talking about. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the guru of graft. It's Howie Carr.
Hey, Howie, I see you got a haircut again.
Yes, I did, Grace. It looks good, doesn't it?
It definitely looks better than that haircut you got a few years ago before you met the president. Remember that bad buzz cut, Howie?
Geez, you love bringing that up, don't you?
Well, I just think that your bad haircut was a true testament to the wonderful work of Dr. Hines at DiStefano Hair Restoration. Because even though you looked crazy at the time, your hair grew back, and now you look as dapper as ever.
That's true. Dr. Hines did such a wonderful job on my hair. I love waking up every day not worrying about bald spots or a dreaded comb over. I now have a thick head of hair, and the best part of it is, it's my hair. Getting a DiStefano hair restoration was the best decision I ever made.
Well, besides hiring me, right, Howie?
Like I said, Grace, it was the best decision I ever made.
You heard him, guys. Go to hairman.com to get the hair you've always wanted. Get hair like Howie's. Go to DiStefano Hair Restoration. They have 5 locations in New England, and they are open for business. That's hairman.com. Normally, we give Fredo Cuomo a lot of attention, but lately, it's Governor Andrew Cuomo who's been grabbing headlines. Let's take a listen to some of his best moments.
You're an essential worker, so go take a job as an essential worker.
But the people aren't hiring because of the
pandemic. No, there are people hiring. You can get a job as an essential worker. So now you can go to work and you can be an essential worker and you're not going to kill anyone.
The number is down because we brought the number down. God did not do that. Fate did not do that. Destiny did not do that.
We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
Because I can all see you are in masterful shape, buff even.
It has a very nice floral bouquet. A little I detected lilac, hydrangea, tulips. What does it smell like to you? Tulips, yes. Floral bouquet.
Because if that's who they are, and if they are the extreme conservatives, they have no place in the state of New York.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with. Consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much, but no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gunnar is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
This is Jay in Hingham, Massachusetts.
This is Gloria from Haverhill, Mass.
Hi, this is Joe from Howie in the Hills, Florida. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Raycon's newest wireless earbuds, the Everyday E25s, are their best ones yet, with 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, and a noise-isolating fit that really allows you to focus on what you're listening to. Get 15% off Raycon wireless earbuds at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Have you personally observed any mail-in ballot screw-ups yet?
Yes, I have.
18% say yes.
Only 18%?
And you've personally witnessed some?
I got some right in my hand here.
It doesn't come without the receipts, folks.
I decided to do this, and this isn't the only one. I got some text messages and emails yesterday from people. I haven't even checked my mailbox because usually it's just junk mail, but I have a feeling I've got multiple mail-in ballot applications, just like I had before the primary. But I'm surprised it's only 18% because I'm hearing a lot more about it than that. And I just wanted to bring this up and maybe discuss it because I know a lot of you are concerned about it. And I don't know really what to do about it. People that lived in Weymouth, okay? Birchbrow Avenue in Weymouth. They moved to they moved to Florida over a year ago, and the husband, he was 53, passed away in July of 2019. Their application for mail-in ballots arrived at the house in Weymouth that they sold last year. See attached pics. I got it right here. Holding it up. So this family, which no longer lives in Massachusetts, and one of which no longer lives, period, are being asked if they want to vote with a mail-in ballot in Massachusetts. And I got his obit here from the Patriot Ledger from August the 7th, 2019. He was living in Rotonda, West Florida, formerly of North Weymouth, Mass. He was born in Bitburg, Germany, was a union carpenter for Local 33 in Boston, loved to go fishing and spending his time. And they think he's planning to vote this year. He's dead, and he died in Florida, but he's planning to vote in Massachusetts. And I think there's a lot of this going on. And a woman just called Rush and asked him about it. And said, what are we going to do? And he said, I don't know what you can do. And the guy that sent me this, I said to him, I said, what are you going to do? How are you going to do it? And he's a smart guy. And he said, well, I think you need to prosecute people. But it's too late. The election is only 7 weeks away, right? You know, I mean, they should have prosecuted all those people who voted illegally in New Hampshire, 4 years ago. They didn't. They prosecuted about 10 people. I don't think any of them got jail time. The other thing is that this guy was suggesting is there's a phrase in criminal law,
chain of custody. You know, that means if, you know, like if you find a gun at the scene of the crime, you make a little mark on it. If you're the arresting officer or the investigating officer, and, you know, so you can identify it later on. And then they always make sure that the gun is always in the custody of somebody. And if you lose the chain of custody, it goes out as evidence. I've seen it myself with, I had a tape one time at my old radio station of Zip Connolly. The crooked FBI agent and the FBI agents came, some other investigating FBI agents came by and they said, do you have the tape? We're trying to, you know, strip him of his pension. And I said, yeah, here it is. It's in my desk. And they said, where'd you get it from? And I said, I can't remember. I've had it for years. And that was it. I mean, they couldn't use it because the chain of custody had been broken. How do you keep a chain of custody in this case? Who knows? So all somebody has to do is take this dead person's ballot and mail it in to the Secretary of State, and then the real ballot will come back and they can mail it. It's a lot easier than you know, actually having to go up to the ward or the precinct and say, I'm so and so, and knowing so and so is dead, and then ask for a ballot. I mean, that takes chutzpah to do that. I mean, just filling out a form and putting it in the mail, I mean, that's child's play. That's like stealing an extra M&M at Halloween. It is. 844-500-4242. 774, my daughters are both registered elsewhere, yet we have their applications for ballots. Yeah. I got a letter I got an email today from my daughter in Dallas, and she said, how do I get my absentee ballot in Wellesley? And I said, first of all, why don't you register in Dallas where you live? And she said, because the DMV is shut down because of so-called COVID, you know? And so then I said, why don't you call town hall? And of course, town hall is shut down because of COVID. How convenient, huh? Isn't this convenient that the town hall is shut down? So, I mean, what is she going to do? I know what she's going to do. I won't tell you that. I figured it didn't take me long to figure it out, but then I've been around this kind of stuff for a long time. But, you know, I have a feeling a lot of Trump voters could go down the drain. And you know, the Democrats are going to cheat and cheat and cheat and cheat. 781 says, I got 7 applications, 1 for me, my husband, 4 kids, and 1 of their spouses. It says in red letters, please return by October 20th. How in on earth are all these ballots supposed to be in on time if the application is open until October 20th? We're going to take some calls on this if you want to talk about this. I don't want you to think I'm ignoring this big, big problem that seems to be looming out there. I'm Howie Carr.
The 2020 elections have the potential to shape the next decade financially. That's especially true if you're within 10 years of retirement. Is your plan ready? Find out with a portfolio stress test from Kevin Frisbee at Frisbee & Associates. Call 800-989-9100 for your no-cost, no-obligation analysis. Kevin can help uncover any hidden fees that may be lurking in your plan. Team at Frisbee & Associates are up to date on all the latest rules and regulations, from what the SECURE Act is and isn't to Social Security and Medicare. Let Kevin and the team give you peace of mind as you get near retirement. Make sure your plan is ready for whatever happens come November. It starts with a phone call to Frisbee & Associates, 800-989-9100. And be sure and catch Kevin on the Howie Carr radio program every Thursday at 3:50 as he reviews the market. Call Kevin now at 800-989-9100. 800-989-9100.
Here's 1 minute of Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
There's a lot of restaurants that are feeling the pain of racism, where people are literally not patroning Chinese restaurants. They're not patroning Asian restaurants because of just straight up racism around the coronavirus. So,
you know, only in America does the president, when the president tweets about liberation, does he mean go back to work? When we, you know, have this discussion about going back or reopening, I think a lot of people should just say no. We're not going back to that.
One of the, I know it sounds banal. Do we know how long puppies are allowed to stay with their mothers after a dog has given birth?
I don't.
8 weeks. Wow. So the market has decided that women and people who give birth deserve less time with their children than a dog.
So the whole premise of the Green New Deal is that we're screwed.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They live with me. So they were my dogs. I love those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach about the age of 6 or 7. 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
Here's 1 minute of CNN's Don Lemon.
What do you say to those Trump voters who prioritize the economy over the president's bigotry?
I have a big announcement, and it's somewhere on my body.
Because the biggest purveyor of fake news is the president in this country, because he does it a lot.
I'm just going to speak from the heart here. What we have witnessed was a total eclipse of the fact.
If you thought I went hard in 2019, watch 2020, baby. There's more to come. I'm a soldier. I'm ready to fight.
Talking about the cost of this parade and where there would be tanks, right? And would there be nuclear weapons? Americans, are you mad as hell? I wouldn't normally address this. As a journalist, I don't really like being the story here. Kanye West, entitled to his own opinion, but is not very bright and not very, when it comes, I'm talking about decision, not overall. So we have to stop demonizing people and realize the biggest terror threat in this country is white men, most of them radicalized right up to the right.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. I heard there was a crowd of Trump fans that greeted Biden in Florida. Have you found any videos? I don't know. We haven't seen any yet, but I think that's what I'm told.
The videos, but it's not good for radio.
Yeah, but how many people are there waiting for Joe Biden?
Lots. Oh, they were lining the streets out of the airport. Yeah.
That's good. 844-500-4242. 207 says ballot voter fraud, Midcoast, Maine, New Yorkers, etc. are staying longer here and going to the town to vote and swaying votes to the Dems. And they're also mail-in voting in their home states at the same time. I've seen it. You know, I tend to believe these stories. You know, these Trump derangement syndrome afflicted people really believe this is their religion, defeating Trump. You know, they don't have any they don't have any real religion. So if you believe in nothing, you'll fall for anything. That's an old saying, and it's very true. And this is their religion now. It's not a party, a political party. It's a cult. Increasingly, the Democrats, and it's a cult that prizes orthodoxy overall. You know, that's why we have the cancel culture, the woke mobs coming after people. You know, they got a professor fired somewhere because he went to a Blue Lives Matter rally. And someone took a picture of it on social media, and it was Skidmore College in New York. 844-500-4242. We have that cut of Joe Biden this afternoon.
6,000, as of today, 923. Not roughly 6,900, 923. Because every one of these fallen angels left behind a family, left behind a community.
Fallen angels. That's, I don't know. I think he's, I think it's another indication that he's not all there, not playing with a full deck. Let's have him yesterday. We'll take some calls here in just a moment, but let's play a couple more cuts. Let's play cut. This is from yesterday. He's rambling on about faucets. Cut three.
Environmental justice, so we can turn a faucet on and drink water, breathe clean air. I'm sorry, I'm about to end, but no, live, you know, we have to live. So, I mean, we have to just give people
I'm about to end? I'm about to end? He's going to be a fallen angel in just a matter of seconds. Cut two.
Do I do it now? Bishop, you want me on now?
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
Is it that tough? Is it that tough? I had to address a Zoom meeting on Friday for about a half an hour. And it took me about, I don't know, about 30 seconds to get used to it. And then it was just like talking when I normally talk, when I'm talking on the radio or the TV or to just somebody on the street. Is it that difficult? If you hear the voice of someone you're talking to, it doesn't really matter, does it? I mean, once you get, the guy was only in the Senate for what, 36 years? And then he was vice president for another 8 years. And then he's been running around cleaning up messes made by his coke-addled, whoremongering son, Hunter, for the last 4 years. Good Lord. 844-500-4242. Lee, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Lee.
I believe Joe Biden's lost the chain of custody to his brain. We should use that as evidence. We should use that as evidence to vote against him.
I couldn't agree with you more, Lee. He has misplaced his brain. There's no other way to put it. Thanks for the call. Steve, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Steve.
Hey, Howie. How you doing?
Good.
To coincide with your subject here, there was a case of actual voter fraud in Springfield that I remember. I mean, I don't know how you're familiar with, like, Western Mass politics.
Yeah.
Rafer Pellegrino was the attorney for one of the candidates, and one of the candidates was accusing one side of having dead people voting, until it surfaced that the other candidate had dead people voting. And then the story just mysteriously disappeared.
Well, it's kind of like the recount in Michigan. Remember in 2016, Jill Stein was raising millions of dollars to have these recounts, and they got the legislature, I guess, in Michigan to approve it. And then they started opening the ballot boxes in Detroit, and they'd see like a notation for 300 votes for Hillary Clinton in this ballot box, and they would open it up, and there'd be like 100 votes. And they did that a few times, and they said, you know what? It's probably not good for the future of the Democrat Party and in Michigan to continue this recount. That was the end of the recount. And they said Trump wins the state. And I think a lot of that happens. And there are all kinds of ways to engage in voter fraud. They used to put stickers on. One time there was a guy running for re-election in a state rep race. This was a long time ago and later became a statewide office holder. And the guy running against, he was an incumbent. The guy running against him had stickers. And so he won. And so the incumbent demanded a recount and said, we'll store the ballots in the basement of the church where he worked. And they got the ballots in there and they turned up the heat. They had steam heat in the basement and they just turned it up all the way. And they basically steamed off some of the stickers, enough stickers for him to win. Because if the stickers were gone and they were at the bottom of the box and not on the ballots, that's how he won the election. That's how he stole the election. There's other ways to do it too. I mean, I've told this story before, but in Boston, it was at City Hall. It was explained to me that what you do is, if you get a recount, if you're you find a ballot that has the mark of your opponent on it, what you do is then mark your own candidate. And then you say, I'm pulling this because they voted for two people on the ballot. So you have to throw it out. So you're not making votes for your own candidate. You're negating votes for your opponent. And there's a million different ways to do it. 844-500-4242. Joe, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Joe.
Hey, Howie. How are you today?
Good.
I really think, Joe Biden, he's starting to tell these stories so much, he actually really believes it. He keeps talking, twice in the last month, he's brought up his son, Bo, and he mentions how his son was in the service, and then immediately follows it up by, he died. So
right.
He's giving people the impression that his son was killed in action when he wasn't.
Right. No, I saw that. I saw one of those cuts where he, the guy said, I can't vote for you because you made a wrong vote on Iraq and you killed, you killed friends of mine with that bad vote. And then he said, yeah, my son died. And he made it sound like his son died in the military. Right.
And so you could almost see that. I said, okay, he's trying to cover himself. He did the same thing. An old woman at the 9/11 memorial said she had a picture of her son, obviously nothing to do with the military. He said, oh yeah, my son died too. Mm-hmm. He was in the military, Afghanistan, Iraq, something. I don't know. So
he said, and he always says both his sons were in the military, and Hunter went in at like the age of 40 and was going to be a public affairs officer, and he didn't go through basic or anything like that. And then he got drummed out because he couldn't pass the drug test. He was the urinalysis test was showing up, large amounts of cocaine in his bloodstream. And Joe, he does the same thing with his first wife. He said for years that, I lost my wife whenever he would speak to some group, talking about drunk driving or something like that. He'd say, I lost my wife because the truck driver that hit her had drunk his lunch. And it was totally untrue. It was, she ran a stoplight or something. And it really, it crushed that guy's spirit and his soul that this guy, this national political figure, would basically accuse him of killing his wife and his daughter by driving drunk when he knew it wasn't true. I mean, I don't know if today, who can say what he knows today, but, he was telling this story 20, 30 years ago that his wife was killed by a drunk driver. And it was just total nonsense. But again, he was also the first white student at Delaware State. He played Division I football at Delaware. He came out of a coal mine. So it's all BS. Everything about him. He thinks everything is, in the old days, maybe he was just trying to embellish his background. Now who knows? Mary, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Mary.
Oh, hi, Howie.
Hi.
It's Mary again. My blood pressure is rising, and I'm sick of being in the Twilight Zone. But a coworker of mine is a Democrat, and she told me one day, your boy there wants people to vote twice, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, what are you talking about? I saw what he said, and that's not what he's saying. She said, yes, he is. I go, what? I'm not the brightest bulb, but I watched it, and I know what he said.
He never told people to vote early and often,
No.
I mean, that's ridiculous. Go ahead.
Or twice.
So what did
you
do?
So she sent me an excerpt from CNN News that showed only partial of what he said, and the reporter was saying, this is against the law, blah, blah, blah. So you know what I did? I sent her an excerpt from the press secretary.
McEnany.
Yeah. So I sent her the whole explanation of exactly what he said, and no response. Because I was right.
Don't bother them with facts. Don't bother them with facts, Mary. Thanks for the call. Josh, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Josh.
Hey, Howie. Yesterday I got the things in the mail to, for the voting.
Yeah.
One for my wife and one for my son. They're, independents. And I'm a Republican, so I don't get any. They didn't send me any yesterday or today or nothing.
Wait, your son and your wife, who were unenrolled, got ballots, yeah. But you didn't get a ballot as a registered Republican?
Right.
My God. What town is this or city, Josh?
People's Republic of Newton.
Jeez.
One other thing. Those beat things, could you give out the number?
The super beats?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll get them when we come. We'll give you the info. Let me see if I've got it right here in my my list. I don't have a. We'll get
a website, superbeatsradio.com/Howie, but we'll try to get a number for you.
Yeah, we'll get you a hold on, just hang on, Josh, and we'll have a number for you to call or at least the web address when we come back. Many are feeling nervous about the stock market as the election draws closer. It's important now more than ever to look at where your money is and not put your head in the sand. There was a column about it in the Wall Street Journal yesterday saying this is one of these great run-ups that can could cost you a lot of money if you get caught flat-footed. Bill O'Reilly is here to help you. He's hosting the Great American Wealth Project along best-selling financial author Alexander Green. Their goal to show Americans what it takes to create a dream retirement. Go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on the Bill O'Reilly banner. You should feel secure about your portfolio, about your future. Watch Bill O'Reilly and Alexander Green as they discuss how you can achieve the American dream starting today. Just go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on the Bill O'Reilly banner. Start feeling secure about your life savings and investments today by watching O'Reilly's Great American Wealth Project. HowieCarrShow.com and click on the Bill O'Reilly banner. I'm Howie Carr.
You can call him Fat Boy, just don't call him Late for Dinner. It's Howie Carr.
President Trump is clearly ethically unfit and intellectually unprepared to be the president of the United States. And I support Chairman Woman. In the coming weeks, the House will hold hearings. Congresswoman Harris, Senator Harris. He's our president, and I would rather he not be taking something that has not been approved, especially in his age group and in his, shall we say, weight group, what is morbidly obese, they say. So completely inappropriate in so many ways that it's almost a given. It's like a child who comes in with mud on their pants or something. That's the way it is. They're outside playing. That's what it is. He comes in with doggy doo on his shoes, and everybody who works with him has that on their shoes too. But I only will do that if you tell me that this legislation is worthy of George Kirby's name. This movement of moment of national anguish.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s,
I was going down the stairs and one of the kids' toys was on the stairs and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up and I still have a bridge, a crown from that mishap. I have a replacement hip and now I have a bunch of pins in my left elbow.
When do you plan to retire?
I don't plan on retiring. As an old football coach once said, once you retire, there's only one big moment left. You know what that is.
Hi, my name is Jane Lucas, and I am from the town of South China, Maine.
This is Al from Merrimack, New Hampshire.
Hey, I'm Angela from Brewster on the Cape, and this is the one and the only Howie Carr Show.
This is frustrating because I don't know what to, I'm like Rush. I don't know what to do about this. And the guy who sent me the Weymouth, the dead person in Weymouth, I asked him. He's a smart guy. I've used him on some sneaky stuff in the past, and he didn't know what to do either. This is very frustrating. And, you know, we ask people like Ronna McDaniel, we're suing. I don't know if that's good enough. 617, I'm a letter carrier on the South Shore, and I delivered the mail-in ballot request yesterday. I had over 70 of them that were bad. This is one route. Some deceased people and others who haven't lived at those addresses in 10-plus years. That was just my route. Multiply that by 13 in the town I work in. Same deal with the census. Here's another one, 413, Wilbraham, Western Mass. My son is Republican, nothing received. Wife and I are independent. We receive ballots. 207, we have a guy up here who's lived in Maine for 6 years, and he got 4 ballots from his hometown in Massachusetts. I mean, he's been here for 6 years. WTF. Then I just got this one. This is an email I just got from someone who's a Republican operative. I just got this at our new address. These are good friends of mine from California. They are both Democrats. Somehow they magically got registered to vote at our new home. This is from the Registrar of Voters in Santa Ana, California, which is in Orange County. What a mess. What a mess. Let's see. 508, just heard a guy say his son got a ballot because he's unenrolled, yet he received nothing, and he's Republican. Exact same thing happened to my buddy in Westport. He was complaining this morning. His son got 2 applications. He's unenrolled. Well, my buddy hasn't received one, and he's Republican. Eric, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Eric.
Howie, it's the exact same thing. I'm from Central Maine. My wife's registered Democrat. She's gotten hers. My mother's Democrat. My sister, they've gotten theirs, Republican. I haven't got a thing. And I do know a friend of mine who's a Democrat who got 2 because he moved, I would say, since the last election. That's the only thing I can figure out. He got 2, one for his last address and one for his new one.
What's he going to do?
He's voting for Trump.
Yeah.
But, you know, I told him.
How many times is he voting for Trump? That's my question, Eric.
Yeah, no kidding. I told him to send both in and then go to the voting booth.
I know. I'm not encouraging this, but it has occurred to me that you get the mail-in ballot, then you somehow get town hall to respond, even though they're closed because of the virus, and you get them to send you an absentee ballot, and then you could also, although I wouldn't encourage this, you shouldn't do this, then you could go down and vote on election day, right? So you could vote 3 times. But, you know, I'm not going to do that. I'm sure that I'm unenrolled, so I'm sure that in my mailbox I've got the application for a mail-in ballot, but I'm not going to use it. I'm going to vote once in Florida on election day. That's what I'm going to do. Thanks for the call, Eric. 844-500-4242. Apparently, they're discovering more ballots in Sussex County, New Jersey. 1,600 ballots were found in Sussex County from a July 7th primary. Officials blame COVID. Yeah, COVID. What about the 3,000 ballots in Franklin, Massachusetts? And I'd heard even before then that there were problems in Franklin. People that were getting mail-in ballots were also calling to get absentee ballots. And now the town clerk has quit. and you know, said it's, you know, I tried to do the best job I could, but she gave up. And who knows? I mean, that's one congressional district, the 4th congressional district of Massachusetts. That's where Franklin is. And then you have the problems in the 12th congressional district in New York. That's Carolyn Maloney and the guy she was running against. And God only knows how many more of these problems there are. And what is it going to be like on election day when the Soros operatives are already gaming, quote unquote, that's their word, gaming out what they're going to do to try to, they don't use the word steal, but to win the election after the vote is over, after the voting is over. Larry, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Larry.
Good afternoon. Thank you for your show.
Thank you.
I have a hypothetical question for you. Hypothetical question. Joe Biden is elected president. Joe Biden is inaugurated as president. It's time to do a cognitive exam. One of the questions they always ask is, who's the president of the United States? You think he'll get a run?
I would like it in the debates if they got to ask each other questions, because if I were Trump, my first question would be, Joe, I want you to recite the alphabet backwards. I just want to give him the standard sidewalk Olympics, not because I think he's drunk, but because I think, as the earlier caller said, he's lost the chain of custody of his brain.
U.S. troops died in Iran and Afghanistan.
In Iran. I'm Howie Carr.
You know what? We got us a couple of real Karens here at Matthews Brothers and a Kendra. We also have 8 Bills, 7 Johns, 4 Jims, Richards, and Mikes. What about Bob, you ask? Well, we got 3 of them and 3 Amandas, Garys, Jordans, Kevins, Steves, and Waynes. We've got 2 each of Andys, Angelas, Anthonys, Ashleys, Bryans, Casey's, Charlies, Christopher's, Dan's, David's, Debbie's, Eric's, Jeff's, Jessica's, Joseph's, Joshua's, Logan's, Mason's, Nathan's, Patrick's, Paul's, Randy's, Rick's, Ryan's, Scott's, Tim's, Tom's, Travis's, and Matthew's, neither of them with one T, and 102 other uniquely named individuals. These are the 10 score and 19 people that every day put on their boots, sneakers, or other closed-toed footwear, come in and do their job, whether they work the first shift or second, in scheduling or logistics. The cut line, the screen line, the paint line, or the glass line. Customer service, wrapping, added value are one of the many production lines. They're all part of our legendary Main Made awesomeness. You can learn more about our wicked awesome Main Made windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals, or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. That's Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate. Howie Carr.
We went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were 2. Number 1, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's why I'm saying I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have 3 houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
We all shop online, and now you can do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
You teachers who touch them, figuratively speaking, well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them, too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts.
I get in trouble some of the things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. If I'm your president, with me, it starts here in my gut. Goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand, and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down, so it was straight, and then watch the hair come back up again. $1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
Howie says it all the time. When it comes to bad politicians, Massachusetts takes the cake.
It is my honor to introduce to you your senator, my senator, Senator Elizabeth Warren.
I know who I am because of what my mother and my father told me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Governor Deval Patrick.
And frankly, I got to tell you, with all the other things I'm worrying about, this is not one of them. We're going to be fine. I'm in charge.
Please join me in welcoming our own Senator Ed Markey.
The planet is running a fever. There are no emergency rooms for planets.
The very first African-American congresswoman to be elected from Massachusetts, Ayanna Pressley.
We don't need any more brown faces that don't want to be a brown voice. We don't need black faces that don't want to be a black voice. We don't need Muslims that don't want to be a Muslim voice. We don't need queers that don't want to be a queer voice.
Let's give them a great Waterloo reception. God, Perry.
The Yankees posted the Boston Red Sox logo and they sang Sweet Adeline.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show. And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever. And VB was always saying that we were whipped, if you know what I mean. Finally, I said, you don't even have a girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear?
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020, and that some horrible Democrat will come in and finish off the destruction of this once great country.
Out of all of your daughters, who is the least like you and why?
Probably Charlotte, even though we went to the same high school, Deerfield Academy. She has a different sense of her responsibilities than I do. Let me put it that way. She has a different regard for money. She's not a cheap bastard, in other words. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future future has traditionally met rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever. And VB was always saying that we were whipped, if you know what I mean. Finally, I said, you don't even have a girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear?
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020, and that some horrible Democrat will come in and finish off the destruction of this once great country.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
We need to make sure you have a president in the White House who actually sees you and who has your back. A Harris administration together with Joe Biden as the president of the United States.
Oh, did I say that out loud?
A Harris administration with Joe Biden as the president of the United States.
Inside words stay in, outside words come out. That time an inside word popped out.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Do I do it now? Bishop, you want me on now?
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
You need a lot of energy to do this job properly. You can't be sitting in your basement for 4 days and come out. No, and then he comes out. And I like Delaware. I think Delaware is a good place, but you got to leave it on occasion. You know, I mean.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
It is a historic day at the Trump White House. The delegation from Bahrain also here. The Prime Minister of Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu, is here. Israel to sign normalization of relations documents with the UAE and with Bahrain. This brokered with the help of the Trump administration. Again, a historic day.
After decades of division and conflict, we mark the dawn of a new Middle East. In Israel's entire history, there have previously been only two such agreements. Now we have achieved two in a single month. And there are more to follow.
Unchained and unstoppable.
It's been incredible what we've done, because we're going to have a vaccine in a matter of weeks. Now, will it be before the election? It could be, in terms of we have something and we'll start delivering it immediately upon getting it.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats, beware. It's Howie Carr.
Welcome to the Howie Carr Show. The toll-free number from anywhere in the U.S. is 844-500-4242. You know, I've been thinking about the fires out on the West Coast and the fact that the Democrats, led by Joe Biden or his speechwriters, are all saying this is the fault of Donald Trump. He can do everything. He causes floods in places. He probably caused the hurricane that's barreling towards the Gulf Coast. And he also starts fires. But if fires are really produced on the West Coast by climate change, how come we're not reading about any fires in Mexico or Canada? Only along the American West Coast, Washington, Oregon, California. Could it be because in Canada and Mexico, perhaps if you're caught starting a fire, you will be locked up? You won't be, or at least you'll be given high bail and kept in the hoosegow for a while. Whereas in Oregon, they let a guy go after he started a fire. And so he immediately went out, got himself a new can, filled it up with gasoline, and set six more fires after they had let him go with no bail.
Everybody's always blaming me for everything.
That damn Donald Trump, I guess he got that guy out on no bail. Rodrigo, I think, was his name. Rodrigo Lopez Jr. That's just one thing I'm thinking about.
I thought his name was climate change.
Climate change. There was a woman down in Southern California who was starting multiple fires. Maybe her name was climate change.
Don't forget the gender reveal.
Yes, the gender reveal. There were no gender reveals until Donald Trump came along. He was the one who started that whole gender reveal thing, and now there's thousands of acres up in flames.
Everybody's always blaming me for everything.
You'd think that the fire would have been the end of the gender reveals, but alas, it is not. People are still doing it.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Pyrotechnics, cakes with frosting and all balloons and all sorts of things. Anyway, though, Howie, this is time for Grace's News, and we've got a lot of news to get to. I want to start with the Harris administration.
Harris administration, yes. Now both Joe Biden and Kamala Harris are talking about it.
We talked a little bit about this in the first hour. So yesterday, Kamala Harris, I guess it was a Freudian slip. Taylor and I have different theories on it. Let's hear that cut, and we're going to dissect this. This is cut number one.
You need to make sure you have a president in the White House who actually sees you, who understands your needs, who understands the dignity of your work, and who has your back. A Harris administration together with Joe Biden as the president of the United States, the Biden-Harris administration will have access, provide access to $100 billion in low-interest loans.
Yeah, she tried to backtrack it. Hers was definitely a mistake. She, like you said in the intro, Taylor, her inside word came outside. Now, let's listen to Joe Biden today. This is cut 16.
Biden administration is going to relaunch. Harris Biden administration is going to relaunch that effort.
That one I don't understand.
What do you mean you don't understand it? We listen to these cuts day after day, and he's always mixing up words. He pronounces president as precedent. He calls economists echo nuts. You see it every day. There's three, four, five of these moments, moments.
But I think the part of it that drives me the craziest, or at least if I was part of his, team would drive me the craziest, is it seems like the thing they want him to avoid most when he goes out there, he always goes to. Like, he'll try to say the preamble, and then the next time he'll go out and he'll start up with that again. He always goes to numbers, even though he can't do numbers. So it seems like the day after she says this, they might say to him, listen, Biden-Harris administration, don't mess it up. He goes right out, and it's like the second thing he says, the Harris-Biden administration. He can't help himself.
Have you ever had someone in your family that was in Joe Biden's condition? It's kind of difficult.
It is. And I do feel bad for him. I think he's getting very frustrated out there. And, we're watching him. He always said, watch me. And now we're watching him. And it's not good. But there's another story that came out today about Kamala Harris. It says, this is from the Daily Mail. Howie always points out, we have to go to the Daily Mail, the UK rag, to get any good press, any good stories about our politicians. That's how sad the state of our media is in the United States. It says VP hopeful Kamala Harris, who says she supports defunding police, is seen in Miami being protected by dozens of cops as well as a Secret Service agent carrying an assault rifle, a weapon she's vowed to ban. You guys will remember when she was running in 2019, she promised to ban assault weapons within the first 100 days of her term. She said that she would do an executive order. She would sign an executive order.
Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, consistency is the hobgoblin of small minds. Why do you expect that Kamala Harris would have a problem with an AR-15 protecting her? She doesn't want you to have an AR-15 to protect yourself. She's a very important person.
Right.
She used to work under Willie Brown.
She's going to be the president of the United States.
Right. It's going to be the Harris administration.
With Joe Biden. It reminds me of, when they do an intro to a TV show and there's someone who's more important than everybody else and they say featuring or with. That's what it's like. It would be like me saying The Grace Curley Show with Howie Carr. You'd be a little offended, wouldn't you?
Somewhat.
Yeah, so we will keep an eye on that. But the pictures are going everywhere on Twitter of her being guarded by all of these people.
It's like Bloomberg.
You remember Michael Bloomberg? I mean, he spent tens of millions of dollars. Now, I mean, we're not talking about the Florida TV spots he's buying now for Joe Biden. We're talking about when he was mayor of New York, he tried to organize all the mayors into this basically a lobbying group to get rid of the Second Amendment.
Right.
And so you'd see him going to these places and he would be surrounded. He's a very short guy, about 67 inches tall. And he's surrounded by all these guys, these former New York City cops that are this much taller than him. And they all got guns. They all got shoulder holsters. It's easy for him to talk about the Second Amendment when he's got heat.
Right. Protection for me, but not for thee.
Right.
Speaking of New York here, Mayor Bill de Blasio is changing his mind again and reverses. This is a very interesting story about the homeless people. So in New York, they decided to put all of these homeless people in luxury hotels, or what used to be luxury hotels.
San Francisco, too.
They're not luxury hotels anymore. But de Blasio U-turns again and reverses decision to move homeless people out of luxury hotel on Upper West Side following protests and despite fury from locals over drug use and lewd displays. This whole thing has been a complete disaster. He can't seem to figure out what to do about it.
These people on the Upper West Side, they're all super big liberals. I think this is Nadler's congressional district, and they have just turned on him so completely. I know someone who's got a son who goes to a university in New York City, and he lives in that area. So she's become like a sort of a member of this group, you know, a Facebook group. And these people are so angry at de Blasio, as well they might be.
You know how they say a Republican is a Democrat who's been mugged?
Right.
You could say a Republican is a Democrat who's had mass amounts of homeless people move into luxury hotels down the street from them.
Here's another story related. This is Staten Island, obviously, a different borough. Joyce's Tavern on Staten Island had never been visited by the state liquor authority before the pandemic, but then they decided to hold a charity event for the Tunnel to Towers organization, you know, which raises money for you know, to support causes that are favored by people who survived 9/11. So now they're gonna lose their liquor license. They're gonna be fined $25,000, which City Councilor Joe Borelli predicts will put the Joyce Tavern out of business. This is the way New York City is run these days.
But it's interesting because
it's like Venezuela.
There are all of these rules, or there are all these ideas from Democrats, and it's been happening for decades and decades and decades. And it seems like right now, Howie, in this moment, it's all finally catching up. All these decades of poor government and bad ideas are catching up. And the people who are in the Upper West Side, they're a perfect example. They're looking around going, oh, this can't happen. This is what you wanted.
Message to everyone on the Upper West Side, don't move to any Republican areas,
please.
Okay? Try to clean up your own mess first. Or if you have to move to L.A. or San Francisco or Provincetown.
It's like what New Hampshire people say when all the Massachusetts people start showing up.
Right.
Leave your voting records behind,
right.
Please.
Right. There's a reason you're an economic refugee, because you made some bad votes for a number of decades. If you're thinking of replacing your carpets due to pet stains and odors, you must try Genesis 950 first. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors so they're gone from carpets and padding for good. You can use it in a carpet cleaning machine, and it's green, so it's safe for family and pets. It was the go-to cleaner for when Mr. Gooner had an accident, as older pugs and other dogs often do. Before you purchase any new carpeting, you must try Genesis 950. 1 gallon of industrial strength Genesis 950 makes up to 7 gallons of cleaner. And it's not just for pet stains. It's a disinfectant that kills viruses. It's also great for kitchens, garages, grease stains, wheels, tires, and more. Save yourself the trouble of going to the grocery store or the warehouse store and seeing your favorite cleaner sold out yet again.
And Howie, a lot of people always ask me, do you guys really use it? Do you really use Genesis? I use it almost every single day.
Right. And
I love the spray bottle. It comes out. It cleans everything. You get a lot of product for what you're buying, and it's just great. And like you said, if you don't have pets, you have a kitchen. You have a bathroom.
Yeah. And my daughter Carolyn swears by it. We brought her some down to her new house, and she couldn't believe how well it worked.
It's made in America, and as we like to say, buy American, support America. Order a gallon direct at genesis950.com. Enter code Howie to get more than a $10 value in savings, including free shipping and a free spray bottle with a one-gallon purchase of Genesis 950. Go to genesis950.com and enter code Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by the Villa in Wayland, celebrating over 70 years in business. From my favorite veal parm to their seafood dinners, the Villa has all your home-cooked favorites. Who loves you, baby? The Villa, that's who. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker, Nancy Pelosi.
But, again, don't...
You have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
It's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame. Except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a two-year contract. You just order online, set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
It's time for quarantine questions. You're up, Jared. What have you been eating the most during this quarantine?
I've been eating a lot of Indian food because that's all that's in the machine downstairs, and I'm really growing to like it.
What is your drink of choice during the lockdown?
My drink of choice, I'm definitely a scotch guy. A nice Dewar's really does it for me.
What about a non-alcoholic drink?
Coffee.
What one TV show would you recommend to people who are quarantining right now?
One show? Star Trek The Next Generation. You can't go wrong. It's got everything you want. It's got high concept science fiction. It's got humanity. It's got great characters. It's the last truly great television show.
What is the biggest pet peeve about being at home?
I can see all the dirt that I don't clean, and it mocks me.
What is the biggest silver lining of staying at home?
I'd say wearing sweatpants, but I do that most of the time anyway. I'll say wearing my Spider-Man costume and not being judged.
What's one book you're loving right now?
I'm a big comic book guy, so I'm reading a lot of comic books. Right now, I'm going back over the classic Stan Lee, Steve Ditko, Amazing Spider-Man run, about the first 40 issues.
This is Alex from East Bridgewater, Mass.
This is Ann in Saco, Maine.
This is John Zuko from Hanson, Mass. And this is The Howie Carr Show.
Raycon's newest wireless earbuds, the Everyday E25s, are their best ones yet with 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, and a noise-isolating fit that really allows you to focus on what you're listening to. Get 15% off Raycon wireless earbuds at buyraycon.com/Howie, buyraycon.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Have you personally observed any mail-in ballot screw-ups yet?
Yes, I was just holding some up, and I've gotten a lot more evidence since then in the first hour of the show. These were ballots delivered to a Massachusetts resident who moved away from Massachusetts to Florida and then died more than a year ago, and he just got his application for a mail-in ballot.
80% say they have not observed personally any mail-in screw-up.
And I know this sounds obvious, but if you get a mail-in ballot and you're not planning on using it, rip that thing to shreds. I've seen people throw them away full, as if someone's not going
to
grab it.
Send it to me, and I will dispose of it. For Honest Howie's ballot disposal. I offer the same service if you're a woke person and you're offended by the picture of Andrew Jackson, that racist Democrat president, on the $20 bill. I will dispose of all your legal tender with that racist photograph on it.
You're such a good person. You are such a good person. You're so giving.
Yeah. And I will do that for the donut. Just send it to me.
Free of charge. You right. Heard it here first.
I'll dispose of that double sawbuck.
So we have a very interesting story here about a Biden surrogate who's also semi-famous, I would say B-list celebrity. But before I get to that, I want to let everyone know.
Semi-famous, that means I'd never heard of him until the FBI raided his place today.
For you, he's D-list. For me, he's a B-list celebrity. But before I get to that, Grace's News is brought to you by Toyota of Portsmouth, the house of value. I absolutely love my new RAV4 XLE. The VIPs, you guys can check it out. It's in the parking lot. It's beautiful. You cannot miss it. But even more amazing than the car was the process of getting it. I went to Toyota of Portsmouth. They're located just south of the Portsmouth traffic circle off 95. But you can visit them at toyotaofportsmouth.com. Or visit them at the showroom. It's beautiful. It's clean. You can see Jim Boyle. You can see everyone there who's so nice. Whether it's you're leasing or buying, whatever you're doing, it's the place to go. Tell them I sent you. They're big fans of Howie. So that's toyotaofportsmouth.com. Now, let's get to this B-list celeb. Netflix star and Biden surrogate Jerry Harris raided by FBI.
How many of the VIPs? There's five of you in the room now. How many of you have heard of him?
Oh,
one out of five.
We got one hipster doofus. Yeah. Netflix star and Biden surrogate Jerry Harris raided by FBI for allegedly soliciting photos and sex from minors. So I will explain who this person is.
Anthony Weiner?
His name is Jerry Harris. He's the star of Cheer. So Cheer was on Netflix. It was a documentary series about cheerleaders.
This was Cheers?
No, not Cheers. Cheer.
Okay. Sorry.
And it was about cheerleaders. It was a reality show basically about cheerleaders. I never watched it, but he became a huge social media star. Like, he was on red carpets. He was, I think, with Ellen DeGeneres on her show. He was at award shows.
Oprah.
He met all these celebrities. He was America's sweetheart for like 2 months, as long as you can.
America's sweetheart.
That's
really a poor choice of words, Grace, when you think what he's charged with now.
Well, I don't have a sick mind, Howie. My brain isn't in the gutter. I just mean everyone loved him for a while. He was a big star. Now they're saying that the FBI agents executed a search warrant at Harris's home in Illinois. The investigation was launched after allegations made against 21-year-old Harris by 14-year-old twin brothers. They have Snapchats going back and forth with him and the victims, the alleged victims. And it's not looking good for Jerry Harris.
Harris is from Illinois. Does he know Jussie Smollett?
It does not say whether or not he knows Jussie Smollett, but he did.
Different part of the state. He's from Napierville, I think.
He was encouraging young black voters to turn out on Election Day. And
apparently the younger the better, as far as he's concerned.
He filmed a short video with former Vice President Joe Biden.
With Joe Biden?
Yes.
Could Tara Reid be reached for comment?
His whole shtick was that he was super positive because the show was about cheerleading. So he would, you know, encourage you. It was called Matt Talk or something, where he would say like, yeah,
Matt
Howie,
Talk?
You're the best.
Joe Biden thought it was Matt Locke.
But it's not looking
good.
Where's
Sheriff Taylor? Is Barney Frank in this version?
And this part also says in February, Harris stood on a Dallas stage beside Oprah Winfrey, who handed him her microphone and asked him to pump up the crowd with his signature, Matt Talk.
Pump up the crowd? Unfortunate choice of words.
Oh, God.
I'm Howie Carr.
Do you have no water, poor water quality, or low pressure? This is Howie Carr. Call the local water service experts, Skillings and Sons. They're ready with 24-hour service with no extra charge for after-hours calls. And a fleet of trucks stocked with parts to make sure you're not without water. With over 50 years of experience, they take pride in having a family of employees that are the best in the business. For all things water, Skillings and Sons is there for you. Skillingsandsons.com.
Alexander Hamilton said, "Those who stand for nothing will fall for anything." This is Toby from Cape Gunworks. When our founding fathers drafted the Second Amendment, there was no question of its meaning. Today, if you have questions, come to Cape Gunworks for some advice, training, or to send a few rounds downrange. We have a fully stocked pro shop with a huge selection of guns, crossbows, archery, classes, rentals, a 15-lane range, and a friendly staff. Come on down to Cape Gunworks, Airport Road, Hyannis, or CapeGunworks.com.
Joe Biden accuses Trump of being a racist, but if you listen to Biden's comments, you would agree that he doth protest too much.
If you take a test where you're taking cocaine or not, what do you think, huh? Are you a junkie?
What are you, the first mainstream African-American who is articulate and bright and clean?
And Madam President, we have predators on our streets.
That kid wearing a hoodie may very well be the next poet laureate. And not a gangbanger.
They are beyond the pale, many of those people.
God love you, you've been here all day. My Lord, you may feel like you're being incarcerated.
We have no choice but to take them out of society.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
I think the two-party system is good for the South and good for the Negro.
They're gonna put you all back in chains.
Unlike the African-American community, with notable exceptions, the Latino community is an incredibly diverse community. With incredibly different attitudes about different things.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, then you ain't black.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day. Once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If Mr. Gunner was a person, what college would she attend?
The U.S. Coast Guard Academy.
Is Mr. Gunner a conservative or a Democrat?
Mr. Gunner is a fiscal conservative and a social liberal.
If you could have dinner with any president, dead or alive, who would it be?
Calvin Coolidge. He was from Massachusetts, and I liked his attitude towards public sector unions. And he said, the business of America is business. He's my guy.
Other than yourself, which columnist do you respect the most?
The late George Frazier. He was a columnist for the Boston Herald, the Boston Globe. Most people have forgotten him now. Jimmy Cannon was pretty good. He was so good that Mike Barnicle used to steal stuff from him all the time. Breslin was good in his early days, not so good later on, but when he was working for the Herald Tribune, back when I was a kid in New York, he was damn good.
He's the co-sponsor of the Green New Deal, so what better time to play some of his greatest hits? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Mr. Frosty.
This is going to be a mission to save all of creation.
If you want to ignore that these changes are taking place and that they're having a dramatic impact, then you are in the right place.
You know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock? You know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock, Senator?
Well, here is the thing.
You don't. How long has your family been in Massachusetts?
We are new arrivals, and
Mr. President, American history was made last night. The Boston Patriots won the Super Bowl.
When the Second Amendment was written in order to maintain a well-regulated militia, they did not have in mind that people could purchase guns indiscriminately.
the president is acting like Pontius Pilate.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studio.
844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. So the mayor of Boston, Marty Walsh, has decided to extend outdoor dining in Boston. And so instead of having the last day of outdoor dining in Boston being Halloween, October 31st, it will now be December 1st. So I'm kind of guessing that unless we get some global warming in late November, business is going to plummet around Thanksgiving. I don't remember actually being around here at many Thanksgivings where I've said, let's do the Thanksgiving dinner outdoors. Usually there's a cold drizzle, if not snow, coming down. All the leaves are off the trees, but hey, they're gonna allow the restaurants to stay open outside. What a great development, huh? 844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show if you'd like to join us here this afternoon, every weekday afternoon. And there's a lot of stories about that. I don't know if you saw it this morning. President Trump was on Fox and Friends, and he was talking. He said, "I tried to read the Woodward book, Rage. I tried to read it last night." He said it was one of the most boring books I've ever read. He said it was terrible. He said there was nothing in it. And it was strange because there's a review in the Wall Street Journal today of Rage. And the guy says exactly the same thing. It's the most boring book he's ever read. We'll get to that in just a moment. Now, here's a book that is not boring, and it's called The Stakes, America at the Point of No Return. And it's written by Michael Anton. And Michael Anton wrote one of the great, great columns of recent years. It was called, in 2016, it was called the Flight 93 Election. And he compared the election and the fact that Hillary Clinton was going to, do away with the First and Second Amendments. She was saying that, not in so many words, but that's what her plan was. Open borders, pack the Supreme Court. And that the people of the United States, the voters, had to do the same thing that the passengers on Flight 93 did when it was flying over Shanksville, PA, and headed for the White House, and just take it down. And so he's got a new book out now. It's called The Stakes, America at the Point of No Return. Michael Anton, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Thank you.
So you laid out what was at stake in 2016, I thought, perfectly. But you're saying 2020 is an even more important election. Is that right?
I think so, or at least as great. I mean, to me, the stakes are, are we prepared to accept or have forced upon us blue state politics from coast to coast? So one party state, I know you're in Massachusetts. I guess you guys occasionally elect a Republican governor, so maybe it could be worse. I'm from California. We don't do that anymore. It's a supermajority in both houses of the state legislature, and all Democrats control all the statewide offices, the congressional delegation, et cetera, and they just implement everything they want. It's hyper-liberalism without opposition and without any breaks, and that is what terrifies me for the United States of America and what I thought a Hillary Clinton victory in 2016 would have resulted in, and what I'm still fairly sure that's what a Joe Biden victory will result in.
Yeah, and I was just thinking about the Democrat control in California. Back when you had occasional Republican governors in California and a fairly sizable Republican contingent in Sacramento, you didn't have all these wildfires either, did you?
No, I mean, they're trying to blame it on climate change when really, if you read, for instance, Victor Davis Hanson, who's a fellow native Californian,
right,
unlike me, still lives there, he will tell you that extreme environmentalism essentially forbids the clearing, brush clearing, controlled burns, the clearing of dead trees and things like that, because people think, well, you can't, how dare you touch nature? And the the tinder, this very dry brush and dead wood, builds up over time when environmentalists won't let you do any cleanup, and makes these fires, which to some extent, fires, you know, are, wildfires are inevitable, but makes them much worse than they would right. have to be if environmentalists would let the state do ordinary forest management.
Right.
And
maintenance. What it used to do until very recently.
What it used to do.
Right.
I mean, I grew up in the state, and the fires that we've seen in the last decade or so are orders of magnitude larger than anything I can remember from my childhood. And so to that, they'll all say, okay, well, it's got to be climate change. Well, you know, maybe. I somewhat doubt it. But here's the thing. We absolutely know that we don't do forest management like we used to do. That's a fact. And, you know, you got to have to, rather than just assert an unproven theory, and I believe it is unproven, right? Somebody was arguing with me just the other day saying, but science. Well, the scientists don't actually all agree. It's a myth that all scientists agree that climate change is happening the way that the left says it's happening. But it is a fact that California stopped doing regular forest management right. and that these fires got worse at that time.
Well, I think there have been actually state reports out of California in the last couple of years saying that the state has really done a terrible job of forest management. And Gavin Newsom, the governor, even mentioned it. He even admitted it early on when he was talking to President Trump yesterday. And then he later on reverted to climate change. But he kind of let the cat out of the bag that there are all these problems. And you're right. I mean, if we had New York, California, New Jersey, and I would include Massachusetts because we have a Republican governor, but he's really a Democrat. I mean, these are the states that have mismanaged they have very high rates, not California so much as in the Northeast, but they have very high COVID death rates, and they also have the highest unemployment rates in the country. So the more government has gotten involved in this pandemic, it's the same thing. The more dysfunction we've had, right?
Well, what I've noticed happen in California over the years, and I've also lived in New York, is that very liberal, far-left, blue state governance tends to focus on unrealizable, fantastical things, like famously in California, the high-speed rail to nowhere and stuff.
Right.
And as the government ceases to be able to solve basic problems and do things that governments have been doing for decades, if not centuries, and had been doing them well, it stops doing those things or finds itself unable or unwilling to do those things. And, you know, California can't keep the lights on. It can't pave a road. It can't keep the streets clean. There's all kinds of things it can't do. Diseases that had been essentially considered wiped out for centuries
right.
are now rampant in San Francisco and L.A. And in the meantime, they say, well, we're going to have 100% green energy by 20 whatever, and we're going to build the train to nowhere and do all of these things. It's like, you guys can't wash a street, pave a street, or keep a power plant running. How are you going to do, you know, all of these other things? The answer is, of course, that they can't. And the expansiveness of their vision is meant as cloud to cover up the fact of their total incompetence at the basics.
I'm glad you mentioned high-speed rail because, as you know, Joe Biden, I'm looking right now at one of his campaign promises, quote, an end-to-end high-speed rail system that will connect the coasts. That's interesting because, like you said, they can't connect Bakersfield to San Francisco in California, but they're going to extend to 3,000 miles.
I have no problem with rail. I've used Amtrak in the Northeast Corridor where it makes sense many times because it's a densely populated part of the country where the cities are relatively close together. But the United States is not Europe. It's a much larger country. It's a continent-spanning country. It's really far from one coast to another, and it's just a fact that rail is always going to be slower than air, and most Americans are, you know, not going to want to travel by rail. And the massive expense of building some kind of coast-to-coast rail is crazy because you'll never recoup the investment, number one,
right.
So it's a money loser for sure. But people won't, you know, if you're a business traveler or even a vacationer looking at a five-hour transcontinental flight or however many hours or days a rail trip costs,
days.
You're almost always going to take the flight.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Right. So the California high-speed rail, by the way, was begun and is not completed. It's sort of rotting or rusting like an ancient ruin in the Central Valley, and probably, as far as I can tell, will never be completed. So all of the money spent on it will have just been sunk, and California will have nothing to show for it.
It'll be like the aqueducts, the difference being that in some cases the aqueducts are still used to transport water 2,000 years later. This thing would never have done one single train.
We'll have never carried a single train, right?
We're speaking to Michael Anton. He's the author of the new book, The Stakes, America at the Point of No Return. And I was just reading your column, The Coming Coup, and you've been on with Mark Levin talking about this. And tell us about this gaming of the game out the various outcomes of the 2020 election. This is a George Soros financed operation, right?
He apparently paid for some of it, and someone who works for him or used to work for him was one of the people who organized it. So a bunch of senior Democrats and never Trump former Republicans got together to say, you know, let's play out various scenarios for how the election happens. And one that was the most hair-raising was a clear Trump win in the Electoral College, but a Biden winning the popular vote. In other words, exactly the same scenario that happened in 2016. And the person playing Biden, who was former Clinton Chief of Staff John Podesta, refused to concede and instead got on the phone and started urging governors in states that Trump won to send, you know, what are so-called faithless electors. In other words,
right? They tried that in 2016.
Vote the opposite way,
right?
They tried it, but this seems like a more serious planned ahead effort, because 2016 was a surprise. They didn't think they were going to lose, and so they weren't prepared to monkey around with the results in the same way. Whereas they must be deathly afraid this time that they might lose, which is why, at least this is what I think, which is why they are gaming out all of these scenarios for how to turn a loss into a win, or how to, you know, even if they lose, manage to take back the White House some way. And the scariest part was how they, well, openly, including up to and including Biden himself, were talking about using the military to quote, drag Trump out of the White House, unquote, which I find extremely scary. And I've said, you know, to military friends of mine and colleagues quietly, like, look, you guys, if you even hear any of this talk in the ranks, please tell your colleagues in uniform to just knock it off and cut it out. You have to maintain loyalty and fidelity to your oath, to the Constitution, to the country, and to the institution of the military, some of which date back, you know, the U.S. Army dates back literally to the Revolution, actually before the signing of the Declaration of Independence. So it would be a horrible thing for the military to get involved in this in any way, I think.
Right, and apparently a lot of the conservative upper ranks of the military were purged during the Obama years. So it's not the same military political beliefs wise that it was even 20 years ago.
I fear that is true, but I wonder how far down that sentiment, you know, how far down the chain that sentiment goes. I'd like to believe that the majority of officers and enlisted personnel, if someone attempted to give them an order to interfere in the peaceful transition of power, would simply just refuse to follow that order and call it what it is, which is an unlawful order.
Michael Anton, I appreciate your work, and I'm looking forward to reading your new book. It just came out, The Stakes, America at the Point of No Return. Thanks for being with us, Michael Anton. If you missed out on the cheap bastard deal for Eden Pure Pain Cream that sold out in minutes, you don't need to be depressed. You can still get $20 off your first 3-ounce tube with Howie's big discount. Just use code word Howie at checkout. I've been using Eden Pure's pharmaceutical grade pain cream, and it has really taken away the pain I felt for years in my left leg. The cream starts working in minutes. I broke my left leg years ago and then my ankle later, and as I've gotten older, it's been giving me more trouble. But now I put the cream on in the morning and then again before I go to bed. The 3-ounce tube, look at how big it is. It could last for months. A little goes a long way. Eden Pure's pain cream has FDA-approved ingredients and is designed to maximize the highest amount of relief at the most affordable price. The cream is only $39 with code word Howie. Much less than prescription drugs, it feels like a pricey prescription cream to me. Eden Pure Pain Cream is made in America, and as we like to say, buy American, support America. Get a tube today at EdenPure.com. That's EdenPure.com. And don't forget code word Howie to save big. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here. The captain will be back after this.
President Trump's life has changed a lot in the last couple of years, but one thing that remains consistent, his love for a good nickname.
What happened to Minnie Mike? Where is he? Minnie Mike, I've had him up to here. Sleepy Joe has no idea what he's even talking. He doesn't even know what he's talking about. Sleepy Joe, get off the stage, please.
I don't think the guy's got a chance. Sleepy Joe, I don't think he's got it.
I don't know. I think Sleepy Joe may be able to limp across the finish line.
Crying Chuck. I don't want to say Crazy Nancy because if I say that, you're going to say it's a copy of Crazy Bernie, and that's no good.
Who did you? Alfred E. Newman.
You know, I thought Pocahontas was gone, left in embers. I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year.
Did you ever hear of Pocahontas? It's Pocahontas, Elizabeth Warren.
Little pencil neck Adam Schiff. Got the smallest, thinnest neck I've ever seen.
But Nancy Pelosi, I call her Nervous Nancy.
Crooked Hillary.
Crooked Hillary Clinton.
Bill Clinton said to Crooked Hillary, Crooked Hillary, do you think he calls her Crooked Hillary, Mike?
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Out of all of your books, which is your favorite title and why?
I think my favorite title is Hitman because it's very effective. I thought long and hard about it. We're going to make it Boston Hitman, but then why make it Boston Hitman? Just make it Hitman. Make it a universal subject.
If you could have dinner with one author, dead or alive, who would it be?
I would probably have dinner with William Shakespeare. I know that's a cliche response, but he was the greatest writer in the English language, no question about it.
If you won Mega Millions, would you retire completely?
I used to say no, I would not retire, but yeah, I think I would retire now.
If you had to leave all of your money to one charity, which would it be?
The Salvation Army. I like what the Salvation Army does. I don't think they have too many highly paid executives trying to be social justice warriors.
Hi, this is Val from Long Meadow, Mass.
Hi, this is Tony and Pietra from Haverhill, Massachusetts.
This is Myrnie in Fairfax County, Virginia, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Jim Cramer had Nancy Pelosi, Madam Speaker, on his show today, and I always think of Jim Cramer as being a lib. You know, he went to Harvard Law School, and he's a beautiful person, pretty much. But he was pretty funny this morning. Cut number 9.
Madam Speaker, I'm listening to you, and you, 3 days ago you told CNN that you were optimistic about a deal.
I am.
Really? I mean, I thought I'd take it right off the table right here at this very minute. You got Mark Meadow go and say he was the skunk at the party. He didn't really, you know, he's gotten in the way between you and, I think, Secretary Mnuchin. I mean, what deal can we have, Crazy Nancy? I'm sorry, that was the president. I have such reverence for the office, I would never use that term.
Yeah, sure. That's why you just used it. The chair detects the needle, Jim Cramer. 844-500-4242. And then this was Pelosi's response, proving that the president, once again, is really onto something when he calls her Crazy Nancy.
Anything the president says is a projection of his own insecurities. He calls other people crazy because he knows he is. He complains about this, that, and the other thing because he knows his own shortcomings. He's a master of projection. So anytime he says something, you say, uh-oh, that's what he's thinking of himself. As I do this, I'm touching my pin here, which is a pin that says on it, it's a flag pin, and on it it says, One country, one destiny. One country, one destiny. And that's what we're about.
That's very profound, Madam Speaker. I suppose the most profound thing I've seen since Al Gore was vice president, and he said, e pluribus unum, out of one, many. Can we quote you on that, Mr. Vice President?
Her response was the grown-up version of, I'm rubber and you're glue. What you say bounces off me and sticks to you.
I mean, if anybody has been engaging in projection for the last 4 years, it's been the Democrats. Everything that they've accused Trump of wanting to do, they've been doing in spades. You know, taking away people's First Amendment rights, taking away their Second Amendment rights, violating civil liberties here, there, and everywhere, locking up journalists. Trump hasn't locked up any journalists. It was Obama who locked up journalists. Rena, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Rena.
Hello?
Go ahead.
Hi. I wanted to let Howie know that Ed Markey was putting out tweets about the Portland police routinely attacking peaceful protesters with brute force.
Yes, and I saw that. Yeah.
Yes, and I called his office in D.C., and I called his office in Boston, and I wanted to know which Portland he has been aware of, because it didn't make any sense to me at all. I told him maybe he'd like to live in Wheeler's apartment building where it was set on fire.
Right.
And I suggested that if he's 74 and I'm 72, maybe he'd like to take a walk alone without his security cards in Portland. And
let me read Rena what he said. We're going to talk to his Republican opponent about an hour from now. But this is what Ed Markey, the senior senator, or the junior senator from Massachusetts, said in a tweet yesterday. Portland police routinely attack peaceful protesters with brute force. We must disarm these officers and every other police department in America of weapons of war and enact a nationwide ban on tear gas, rubber and plastic bullets, and beanbag rounds. Is he saying tear gas is a weapon of war? Why does he think people use tear gas, rubber and plastic bullets, and beanbag rounds? They use it, Rena, as you well know, as everyone knows, so that they don't have to use live ammunition. What would have happened if the cop in Lancaster, PA, had not had a firearm, a weapon of war with him, when that guy who was already going to go on trial for stabbing four people was coming at him with a butcher knife? What would have happened? You think a taser would have worked, Ed? Ed Markey doesn't have a lot of law enforcement experience. He didn't run into too many street crimes when he was running the Mr. Frosty ice cream truck. I'm Howie Carr.
If you haven't tried Super Beats soft chews yet, you are missing out. They're really great. They taste great. It's a lot easier and more convenient than using the powder form, and it gives you the same lift of energy.
Howie, we all tried them in the office today. We're having a debate as to which we like better, the chews or the original powder, but they're both great in my opinion.
I like the chews better because I don't have to wash anything afterwards. I don't have to wash a glass and the spoon.
I feel the same way, Howie. They're like Starburst. You can just pop them in and you're all done.
That's right. Order them today. They're great. Super Beets soft chews combine non-GMO beets with a powerful new ingredient, grapeseed extract, clinically shown to be 2 times as effective at supporting normal blood pressure as a healthy lifestyle alone. Do what I did and support your heart health with delicious Super Beets Chews. Get your Super Beets Chews today at superbeetsradio.com/Howie, and when you buy 2 bags, they'll throw in the 3rd one for free. That's superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer! Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark. The Democrat Party is so full of loonies, social justice warriors, progressives, whatever you want to call them, that sometimes certain moonbats get overlooked. So let's take this moment to shine the woke spotlight on Crazy Maisie Hirono.
I am not going to be a fool to Mitch McConnell's shenanigans. Why should any of us?
And it's not just a dog whistle, it's a bullhorn.
Bullhorns. It's racism. It's basically, for many people, it's anti-Semitic. It's white supremacy.
Why not take a stand and vote yes for it? Seems like you're trying to have it both ways. Not be hung by it politically, but also not say that you don't support it.
I disagree with you, Katie, that why should we engage in the kind of sham shenanigans that Mitch McConnell is really good at.
I'm confused.
This was just a sham.
Guess who's perpetuating all of these kinds of actions? It's the men in this country, and I just want to say to the men in this country, just shut up and step up.
I think the noose is closing, and, you know, Giuliani is like a loose cannon, and so is the president, frankly.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer. And I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books. Too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
He's New England's talk radio king. He's Howie Carr.
The only French term I like is sans culotte, without trousers. I used to describe Ted Kennedy as sans culotte. Because he, after the O'Barr incident, when he was wandering around down on the beach after with his 20th scotch tumbler of the day in his hand, stumbling around with an off. He was just there, as the Michelle Cassone, Patches Date, said. He was just there, without trousers. Or as we say in Paris, sans culotte.
We've seen nothing that we can work on. That I can work with President Bush on, and I'm disappointed because I thought that there might be some interest because of what he said in the campaign.
President Bush, this is your brain. This is your brain on Botox, okay? That's the lesson of that one.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
This is the Howie Carr Show, live from Chappaquiddick at the Party House. 25 years after Chappaquiddick 1969. On WHDH, News Talk 850.
Another bad song from 1969. 742-0850. We're going to take some calls this segment if you want to get on board. If you have any questions for John Farrar, the scuba diver who saw Mary Jo Kopechne's body underwater. The number again, 742-0850. We're going to start talking about the incident and everyone's perceptions. John, let me just get this straight. So now, as far as your belief is that while Ted Kennedy was walking past all these houses back towards the party house where we're broadcasting from now, Mary Jo was still alive.
That is correct.
And she would have been alive probably for about an hour, you think?
I think that's most reasonable, and if an hour, if not longer, that's correct.
If not.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now, when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice, one.